A cloudy and in some places snowy start to our morning around southern Colorado. We're going to continue to see that chance for the snow and even some rain in some of those areas off to the south and southeast of the Springs as we go through the rest of the morning. Freedom Financial Services Camera Union and Montebello can't even see the mountains now because the clouds are really covering it up. We saw from the other side of this at Pikes Peak with where we couldn't see the city at all because of all the snow and all the clouds that are blanketing the mountain this morning. 36, the current temperature. Meanwhile, Parkview Medical Center in Camera and Pueblo West, Highway 50 and Purcell Boulevard. Winds out of the northeast at 16 miles per hour. So a lot of the precipitation that's fallen in Pueblo over the last couple of hours has fallen in the wet form, not the wintry form, but that will change over too as we go through the rest of the day today. Highs this afternoon sitting in the upper 30s and lower 40s around much of the region. Your highs in some places are going to be set early in the day, and then temperatures are going to fall back as the afternoon goes on as that push of cool air comes at us from the north. 37 at Walsenburg, 36 for Trinidad. Meanwhile, upper 40s to near 50 in the southeastern plains because you get the cold air last in the southeastern corner of the state. Mountain locations will be sitting in the 20s and 30s. We'll top out at 31 in Salida. As we look at what's happening now in terms of the temperatures around the state, 30 in Fort Collins, 34 at Denver, 32 at Colorado Springs. It's 30s all along the Front Range, lower to middle 40s as you head over towards the Kansas line. Mountain locations are sitting in the teens, 20s and 30s. 17 for Leadville is the cool spot, at least on this map. 32 the current reading in Durango, 30 at Grand Junction, 24 in the northwestern part of the state near the Dinosaur National Monument in Craig. SkyScan satellite and radar shows us that most of the precipitation, at least according to the SkyScan, has now changed over to snow. What it does is it takes the temperature and combines it with the radar itself to give us an idea of whether we're seeing rain, a mix, or just out and out snow. It's all indicated, of course, by the temperatures. And you notice that this band right here, just off to the south of Interstate 70, has changed over now because temperatures have begun to cool off, and that's because that cold air is now invading the region from a northwest. The SkyCast, the projected satellite and radar, shows us it's pretty much all snow all the time as we go through the rest of the evening and into our early Monday morning as we continue to see that cold air make its way into the state. Watch out west of Denver along Interstate 70. Travel plans take you in that direction. Watch out, of course, for closures along the passes and chains to be required. That's also a possibility as we head over to southwestern parts of the state, and there will be some snow north of the Springs up towards the Palmer Divide and Monument Hill. Once again, accumulations not super heavy, but there will be some. And as Zach Pagano just reported to us a minute ago, there have been some difficult conditions north of the Springs up towards Monument. 1 to 4 inches is possible in the areas indicated by the white, which includes up into portions of Douglas County, just off to the north of the Springs, maybe even the north side of the Springs itself, up to a foot and more than a foot in some areas off to the west of the Continental Divide in particular, areas indicated by the darker gray color on your screen. Watch out for some wind, too. This will help to blow that newly fallen snow around that we're going to see as we go through the next day or so. Wind gusts as high as 35 and 45 miles per hour at times, and it's pretty common all around the region, not just necessarily in the plains, not just in the mountains, but it's going to be all over southeastern Colorado over the next day or so. 41 will be your high tomorrow in the Springs after we drop off to 18 tonight. Temperatures as we go through the rest of the week, though, warming up into the mid to upper 50s, so we'll forget all about the snow that falls today, Bonnie, by the time we go into our Turkey Day. Pueblo, mix of rain and snow for you at first, gives way to all snow showers later. Then you top out near 60 by next Thursday and Friday. Canyon City, you'll be sitting in the mid to upper 50s. Lows are going to rise up into the mid to upper 20s. In Teller County, your forecast includes temperatures that'll rise up to near 50 by Friday. So it won't necessarily be as cold as it can be as we're going to get those early morning bargains on Friday.
Ooh, Black Friday. It's always a crazy time of the year. Mm. And as far as this morning, some snowfall could make for some slick conditions. We actually had some drivers out near Monument saying the road conditions are pretty slick right now. So definitely give yourself some extra time. Everyone knows the deal. Take it easy out there.
We know it by now, especially since we've begun to see the snow already. So.
All right. So definitely be careful.